Hi, gang. Man, I'm tired of this cold weather. It's 18 here. I live in Abington, Pennsylvania. Far away from Philadelphia. Notes. Yeah. Somebody asked about Django Reinhardt, what I think. Well, of course, how could you not like Django Reinhardt? He played with so much fire. You have to remember, though, these two fingers were fused together from a fire. A story I heard was that he had some plastic flowers in his caravan or whatever he lived in then. So a lot of his chords were like this, you know, and you know, the fast things that he did that were this, you know. People are thinking, wow, how did he? No. I don't play many of his tunes. The reason being is that his recordings were so badly recorded that he played this chord a lot, you know. So, but you can't hear what the bass note was. If it's an A, A minor sixth, or did the bass player play a D? D9. I mean, the bass player on those recordings sound like somebody hitting a tent with a shovel to me. So I don't play a lot of his tunes because I'm not real sure what it is, you know. And I think that if Django were alive today, he wouldn't be playing the music, you know, that same music, you know. That's my opinion, you know. Yes, it is true. I did get good marks in school. Somebody sent me something about, is it really true you got perfect SAT scores? Yeah, I did. Nobody was more surprised than me. Solid body versus an arch top. Well, you know, I think the thing with guitars are, see, I don't think that matters, what, you know. Somebody plays a solid body guitar, it's not jazz? I don't think so. I mean, Pat Martino plays solid body guitars, did for years. Alan Holdsworth, you know, I knew him a long time. It was funny, there's some picture of me and him together. He was so tall and I looked like I was this big, you know. Great guy, marvelous guitar player. I met him first at Ronnie Scott's in London. And so I don't think solid versus arch top, not valid. The thing with guitars is you have to find a guitar that lets your music come out of you easily. Okay, you don't want to be trying to play something and fighting the instrument. I mean, that's what I go by, you know. And I think that a lot of guys get hung up in the minutiae and miss the forest for the trees. Is that right? Billy Bean. My father knew Billy Bean very well. And Billy Bean learned how to play through copying Charlie Parker licks. He knew all Charlie Parker's solos. It's a shame he didn't get to record more. And like I said in the other videos, a great book about him, written by a guy named Seth Greenberg. Okay. I also think that I have been noticing that there's a parallel between actors or actresses. When I say actors, I mean both. And music, you know. I mean, there were some really fine actors before. I'm a big fan of film noir, the old movies. And it's kind of it parallels what's going on in the music business. I mean, there were so many great actors. I mean, it didn't start with George Clooney. I'll get back to him in a minute. And like everything else, there's a handful of, you know, the more modern or newer actors. There's, count them on one hand. in those days, there were so many great actors and actresses. You know, that's the only worse thing to choose to do in life than being a jazz musician, I think, is I want to be an actor, you know? That's a tough road. You know, when I lived in L.A., everybody I met was an actor or an actress. Said, yeah, but what do you really do? Well, I work at Taco Bell now until I get my big break. You know, I met George Clooney in a very, very bizarre way. His aunt is Rosemary Clooney, who my father played for, okay? And this is going back a ways. This is how long I've been with Concord Records. And I was making a recording, and so was she, in the next studio over in New York. Not another building. It's in the same studio, but, you know, there was a lot of different things. And he kept interrupting the session, you know. No, it's his aunt. And he was so obnoxious that the producer had to ask him to leave, you know? Now, there's a guy who I don't think he can act at all. So all he has is a face. No talent. I don't get it. And, like, making those Ocean's 11 movies, who's he think he is? Frank Sinatra? I mean, Sinatra could act, he could sing. That's a real talented genius. And you got this idiot. George Clooney, give me a break. What a loser. Sorry, George. Yeah, he's really going to care about what I have to say. So there's, you know, it's the same thing, you know, with guitar, or at least jazz players, is, you know, there was music before Pat Metheny, you know? I don't have anything against Pat Metheny. I'm not a fan. You know, I like his tunes. He's doing very well. A very successful guy. So any musician that's making a living, good living, is terrific, you know? Sometimes you have to watch that you don't start to believe your own press, because that can really be dangerous. And so you get the actors from the past, guitar players from the past, kind of parallels, you know, what you see on the screen today, which, you know, pretty weak out there today. I mean, I think Hollywood is run by a bunch of people that, once again, flunked out of Tobu school. Anyway, a little bit of guitar here. I just love these voicings. The bottom two strings and the top two. Another question was, somebody said, how do you I think the guy's point in the question was, how do you separate, your thinking when you're playing versus your thinking when you're practicing? Well, I think the guy that sent me that is confused. I mean, I think that's minutiae sometimes. You know, you can get really caught up in it. I really don't think about it very... I never think about it, actually. Somebody brought up Howard Roberts, you know. I knew Howard Roberts when I lived in L.A. from being around G.I.T. And I didn't know him very much. He always walked around with... dark glasses on, and a Heineken, you know. GIT is still a very fine school. It's run by a very good guitar player, a woman named Beth Marsalis. And school has everything going for it, you know. So I guess that's it for the morning, this morning, checking my notes. And keep playing. Keep sending me ideas. I really like that, you know. I have a friend of mine that's going to put together a concert for me. I can get out of these, nightclub things, you know. Especially the one in Philly, Chris's Jazz Cafe. It's the only place really going. It's the only place that charges a cover charge. And when the original owner owned it, Chris, a guy named Chris Dimitri, I had mentioned to him, you know, Chris, we should start charging the cover. And he had the balls to actually try it. And some, you know, in the beginning, a lot of people would turn away and walk away. You know, at the end of the night, there he is with, like, you know, $4 in the cash register. And we'd sit around and look at each other. And, you know, and I started to feel bad. And he says, Mac, give it some time. So that, and then next thing you know, everybody was charging a cover, you know. So that's it. That's all I got. All right. Stay warm. Cold out there.